Hallelujah. Bless the name of Jesus. Oh God, we praise you today. Oh, you're magnified here on this great Sunday morning. We give you the honor and the glory from on high. We praise your name. We come before your presence with singing and dancing and the lifting of our hands, oh God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. Oh, we praise you, oh God. We thank you for another day that we haven't seen before. Hallelujah. You're glorified. Hallelujah. You're glorified today. Hallelujah. Bless your name, Jesus. We give you the highest praise. Oh God, we love you. Hallelujah. We love you, God. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you for the use and activity of all our limbs on today. Thank you that we're in our right mind. Oh, we praise you right now. We ask that you touch the sick and afflicted today. Touch them, Lord. Touch their hearts, their mind. Heal their emotions right now, their physical bodies, in Jesus' name. Oh, we praise you, oh God. I ask you to go into the rest homes right now. Touch the seniors there, oh God. I come against the spirit of loneliness. I cast you out in the name of Jesus. I cast out the spirit of being alone in the mighty name of Jesus. Touch the staff there. Let them show love right now. Have a caring spirit toward our senior citizens right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, I ask you to go into the prisons, behind prison walls. Encourage those that have given their lives to you. Oh, we thank you for it, God. We praise you. Hallelujah. Touch the grieving families right now. Oh, the Spicer family, the Steele family, the Clem family, in the mighty name of Jesus. And all the families that I have not called out that have lost loved ones during this pandemic, I ask you to encourage them. Cradle them in your arms right now. Let them know you love them and that you're with them and that you'll be with them. Hallelujah. Even until the end of the world. We thank you, God. We praise you now. Hallelujah. You're real. Thank you for being real in our lives right now. Hallelujah. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way, oh God. Touch the pastors. Hallelujah. Touch those in fivefold ministry. Touch right now, God. Encourage, God. Speak through each and every one, Holy Ghost. Thank you for the latter rain and the former rain. We praise you right now for your manifold blessings. Hallelujah. Touch the praise team on tonight. Sing through them, Holy Spirit. Anoint them the more. Touch the musicians. Anoint them the more, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let them sing songs that bring glory to your name and that I keep a smile on your face. We all want to remain the apple of your eye. So we thank you, God, for what you're doing right now. We lift you up right now. In the name of Jesus. Amen, amen, and so be it.
Praise the Lord. We are just honored today to be in the house of the Lord here at Ephesians, and it's a good day for worship. So I just hope that you are ready because we are in for an incredible worship experience. My name is Antoine Timmons, and I'm just grateful for Pastor Lewis Spicer and the Ephesians family for allowing me to lead worship during this whole COVID era. It's been about a year, almost a year and a half or something like that. And I am grateful today because I've got some family with me here.
Yes.
My Love Center family from Love Center Ministries in Oakland. And they are going to bless us today in worship. And so I don't know. I wanted to say fasten your seatbelts, but no, take the seatbelts off.
And,
and just enjoy worship today. The presence of the Lord is here. We've already experienced some of it, but you're now going to join in and experience it with us. So let's welcome today the Love Center Worship Warriors. Amen. The name of the Lord.
Hallelujah. Oh, we're just rejoicing in the presence of the Lord today. Oh, my God. Come on, just worship Him. Worship Him. Chauncey, we got family here today. Ah. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah. Just worship Him. Worship Him. Take a moment. Take a moment. We love you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Oh. All right, here we go. Come on. Mm-hmm.
Oh, how wonderful!
Oh, how wonderful
is the name of the Lord.
Is the name of the Lord. How we worship. His name is to be adored. God our Savior.
Endured pain.
Access our eternal life.
Oh, come on, just relax in His presence. Whoa. Come on, one more time. Hey.
Oh, how wonderful
is the name of the Lord.
Is the name of the Lord. How we worship. His name is to be
God our Savior.
God our Savior.
Endured pain.
So that we access our eternal life.
Somebody give Him a praise.
Come on.
We offer sincere praise.
We offer sincere praise.
We stand.
We stand and bless Your holy name.
For Your blood.
We love You, Lord, today.
Your name is so
Your sweet. Name is so sweet. Your joy is complete. We love You.
We reverence Your face.
We reverence Your face.
Verse 2,
in
verse 2.
Come on. Place.
Jehovah Jireh.
Jehovah Jireh. He who provides for us all our strong tower.
He hears and moves when we call.
Elohim.
Your face.
Hallelujah.
Stay there.
In this holy place, we love You.
We love You, Lord. We love You, Lord.
Your name is so sweet. Your joy is complete. We love You.
Yeah. Give it to Him. Hallelujah.
We reverence Your face.
Take it up. Take it up.
Your joy is complete. We
Nobody like you, Lord. Nobody like you.
Oh, how wonderful.
Stay right there. Stay right there. Come on.
Oh, how wondrous is the name of the Lord.
Yeah, give it to him. Give it to him. Oh, how wondrous.
How wondrous is the name of the Lord.
Can we take it up? Can we take it up? Oh, oh, how wondrous. Can we take it up? Oh, how wonderful.
How wonderful is the name of the Lord.
Lord, we love you, and we adore you.
How wonderful is the name of the Lord.
My God, one more time, one more time. Everybody, come on. Hey, oh, how wonderful.
Oh, how wonderful.
Oh, how wonderful.
Oh, how wonderful.
Is that name?
Is the name of the Lord.
Come on, come on. Let's rejoice in his presence. Oh, oh, how wonderful.
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 Oh, how wonderful. Is that name?
Bless your name. Oh, my my God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hey, go ahead and take a minute and just worship him. Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you for your goodness and your mercies and your grace that is renewed every morning. Lord, great is your faithfulness. You are a faithful God. And for that, we worship you, we honor you, and we admonish you, Lord. We reverence your holy name, God. We give you praise. Now, in the name of Jesus, we call upon your name because your name is great and greatly to be praised. You are the God of the heavens. You are the God of the earth. You are God of all mankind. You are God of all creatures, oh God. And so we glorify your name, Lord, in the name of Jesus. God, we invoke your Holy Spirit to enter now into this place, Lord. And we ask, oh God, and I ask that you, God, would overtake, oh God, your servant now in the name of Jesus. That you would send forth your anointing that makes preaching easy, Lord. Lord, touch my lips, Lord. These lips of clay, oh God. Lord, we ask, oh God, that you would anoint your servant now in the name of Jesus. To bring forth your word, Lord, in praise, Lord. We ask, oh God, that you would just open the ears of the hearers, oh Lord, and that you would, Lord, open the hearts of those, oh God, that are listening today, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Lord, make preaching easy and send your anointing. I ask, oh God, that you would tie my tongues to your truth, that your word would go forth in victory. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. Right there, come on, just put your hands together and glorify him and magnify him. Give him glory, give him praise. For he's worthy of our praise, worthy of the glory, and he's worthy of the honor. We just give God all the glory and the honor on today, amen, for his marvelous works. For he has done great things whereof we are glad. Even in spite of what it looks like, in spite of what it feels like, he is yet still doing great things. He keeps on doing wondrous things. And just with the blink of the eye, praise the Lord, we can see that he's yet still a wonder. Just a blink of the eye, amen. If we just look over yonder, amen, and look at the things, amen, upon the face of the earth, amen, God is yet still wondrous before the eyesight of all of his people. And we just give him glory and we give him praise. We want to go, amen, to the word of the Lord, which is found in Romans 8 and verses 18 through 25. Romans 8, 18 through 25. And the word of the Lord says, "For I reckon that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. For the earnest expectation of the creature waiteth for the manifestation of the sons of God. For the creature was made subject to vanity, not willingly, but by reason of him who hath subjected the same in hope. Because the creature itself also shall be delivered from the bondage of corruption into the glorious liberty of the children of God. For we know that the whole creation groaneth and travaileth in pain together until now. And not only they, but ourselves also, which have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption, to wit, the redemption of our body, for we are saved by hope. But hope that is seen is not hope, for what a man seeth, why doth he yet hope for? But if we hope for that we see not, then we do with patience wait for it." My thought, amen, for the day is, how can I remain thankful and trust God in times of despair? A believer's most daunting question is, after all that I've gone through, What does it take to trust God? Yes, yes, we can maybe even feel this even in these current times, amen. How can I truly trust God knowing all the incidents and the phenomenal current events that are happening around the globe, even the current events that are happening right now, even in our own nation. But as Christians, God's word calls us to consistently give thanks. For it says, amen, in the word, in everything give thanks. For this is the will of God in Jesus Christ concerning you. So instead of complaining, we are to look to God for our daily needs, knowing that my God shall supply all your needs according to his riches and glory by Jesus Christ. Though all we may all may have gone through some devastating experiences over these last few months, how can you be thankful and trust God at the same time when being tried in the fire? One might say, oh, I lost my job and I almost lost my mind. And another might say, nothing went right like I planned, so I'm just going to throw in the towel. And many might say, I've lost my home, I've lost my car, and I'm so troubled I don't know what to do. And some might say, sickness and stricken my body. Famine has struck my home. I feel like the devil is trying to destroy me. But yet, sitting here today, you can say I've been tried in the fire, but I've made it and I still have my joy. I've had some good days and I've had some bad days, but God has been there every step of the way. We must be mindful that Peter even said that in this you rejoice greatly. Though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, that the genuineness of your faith, being much more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire and may be found to praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ. So when the world drops on you, don't be puzzled. Yes, it may hurt. And don't compare your troubles to others. For Peter even said, beloved, do not think it strange concerning the fiery trials which is to try you, as though some strange thing happened to you. But rejoice to the extent that you partake of Christ's sufferings, that when his glory is revealed, you may be also glad with exceeding joy. When life seems full of pain, we must remember that we must endure our tests and trials. For Paul even told Timothy, you therefore, my son, be strong in the grace that is in Christ Jesus. And the things that you have heard from me among many witnesses, commit these things to faithful men who will be able to teach others also. You therefore must endure hardness as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. No one engaged, amen, in warfare entangles himself with the affairs of this life, that he may please him who enlisted him as a soldier. So to be thankful and trust God throughout everything we go through, there are a few principles that are fundamentally biblical to life. One, we should never forget that we live in a fallen world. If things go wrong and trials beset us, this isn't a reflection on the power and the genuineness of God's love. Nor does it necessarily imply that one has sinned against God or even displeased God. It simply means that this old world isn't what it's supposed to be. Just look at what's going on right now. It's not what it's supposed to be. For one psalmist wrote, soon and we'll be done with the troubles of this world. The troubles of this world. But we're going home to live with God. God already told us that the mankind fell from the grace that was to behold this world. And the fall marred the original design of God's creation in many ways. It separated us from God and our true nature. And the fall caused us to rebel against God and engage in denial and self-deception. The fall affected our physical bodies and bringing sickness and death into this world. The fall threw a wrench, amen, into our relationships with one another and introduced pain and suffering into our lives. Because of this world which we live in today, it is not the world God intended it to be. It is in a defective and abnormal matter. Yes, it's in a normal matter. Everything that we see that is going on, this world is in a dysfunctional situation. And the things, man, are bound to go wrong if you put your trust in this world. Yes, we can say it's dysfunctional at the White House and what's going on in even the Executive House. It's dysfunctional. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Look at what's happening now in the state of Detroit. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. The right-wing groups that call themselves Christians but yet still shouting out hate. Amen. Pursued, amen, to kidnap, praise the Lord, the governor of the state. Hallelujah. And then even to possibly even to kill her before the election. Yes, this world is in a dysfunctional state. Look at all the hurricanes that has hit this nation that has come from the Atlantic through, praise the Lord, the Gulf into the coastal Gulf, amen, of the United States. More than that, it has ever been before. This is a dysfunctional nation. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. This is a dysfunctional world. When you look at all the trouble and everything that is going on, praise the Lord, wars and rumors of war. This is a dysfunctional world. Hallelujah. But the good thing news is that God is not content to leave us like we are. For number two, we must bear in mind that our Father in heaven has a plan to fix our brokenness in this present world and heal our pains. God loved us enough that even though we messed up, to send his only begotten son. For the scripture says that for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And for God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. But he that believeth on him is not condemned. Yes, yes, yes. You got to call on his name. You got to believe, amen, in the risen Savior. He that believeth on him is not condemned, but he that believeth in not is condemned already, because he hath not believed in the name of the only begotten of God. Hallelujah. You got to call on his name while he is near. For when night cometh, no man can call. Hallelujah. So this is the day. This is the time. Hallelujah. Now is the time, praise the Lord, that we should wake up out of sleep. Wake up, amen, praise the Lord, from being slothful. Hallelujah. And call on the name of the Lord. Right there, if you want to call on his name, just put your hands together and give him praise. Give him glory and give him thanks. Thank you, Jesus. So the Son of God was sent to reverse the effects of the fall. He was sent, amen, God sent him to reconcile us back to God and to reconcile us to each other and to our true human nature. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. I'm not going to accept, hey, hallelujah, the condition that I am now, knowing that I got to meet the fate, amen, and I have to someday meet death. I believe that there is a life after, hallelujah, and that life after, hallelujah, praise, thank you, Jesus, is something that is, as the old saints, is always howdy, howdy, and always never goodbye. We're going to be praising God and giving God glory all day long. 24/7 worshiping and praise the Lord and giving God glory, giving God praise. No more sorrow, no more pain. Hallelujah. No more sickness. Hallelujah. But we all be giving God praise. Thank you, Jesus. So three, lastly, God never gave us any reason to think that our trials would go away overnight just because we live in Him. But the world says, praise the Lord, that while we live in the flesh, we should expect to experience groanings, but look forward to redemption. For the scripture even says that, for I consider that the sufferings of this present time are not worthy to be compared with the glory which shall be revealed in us. Not only that, but we also who have the first fruits of the Spirit, even we ourselves groan within ourselves, eagerly waiting for the adoption, the redemption of our body. This old body, praise the Lord, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Yes, it will pass by. Heaven and earth, amen, shall pass away. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. But the word of God is the only thing that's going to stand, praise, on this present earth. But there's going to be a new day, a new earth, hallelujah. A new city, a new Jerusalem, hallelujah. That we all will be coming together, amen. All the people of God will come together and we'll sit at the throne of God, hallelujah. And we'll call upon His name day in and day night. So there comes a day when there will be no more sickness and no more death. He will wipe away every tear from our eyes. And until then, there's nothing wrong with being honest about our hurt. There's nothing wrong being honest about our pain that we go through down here on this earth. Yes, yes, yes. Nothing wrong being honest about our frustration. Yes, we're going to get frustrated. Yes, we're going to have some heartaches. Yes, we're going to have some pain. Yes, we're going to have some tribulations. Yes, I've had some hardships, and yes, I've had some hills to climb. But through it all, God's been right there, and here I stand today, and I can say that I've made it, hallelujah. For the psalmist says, I've had many tears and sorrows. I've had many questions for tomorrow, and there's been times that I didn't know right from wrong, hallelujah. But in every situation, hallelujah, God gave me blessed consolation that my trials come to only make me strong. How many witness out there can say that my trials come to make me strong? These are they that come through hard trials and tribulations and have washed their robes in the blood of the Lamb. So if you're hurting, God doesn't expect you to cover it up. Hallelujah. Just call on the name of Jesus and tell Him what you're thinking. Hallelujah. Call on Him and tell Him what you're feeling. Thank you, Jesus. Get a praise in your heart and hallelujah, and bless His name. For it was David said that I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praises shall continually be in my mouth. And my soul shall make a boast unto the Lord, and the humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, and let us exalt His name together. Oh, bless His name. David went on to say, and I sought the Lord, and He heard me and delivered me out of my fears. And I will sing unto the Lord as long as I live. And I will sing praise to my God while I have my being. Hallelujah. While I'm living and I have the activity extremities of my limbs. Now is the time that you ought to be giving God praise. Now is the time that you ought to be calling on upon his name. David went on and said that my meditation on him shall be sweet, and I will be glad in the Lord. Hallelujah. No matter what it looks like, and no matter what it feels like, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus, I'm going to be glad in the Lord. Oh, bless his name. You ought to be glad that God is the God that sits high and he looks low and he sees the way in which you go. And you ought to give him praise and call on his name while he is near. Because when darkness nights come, that there was no time to waste but to call on the name of the Lord. Right there, you ought to call on him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Vow to never be silent anymore and tell him all about your situation. If you tell him, then you can be thankful. If you share it, you'll find that you can trust him. Just know that when in doubt and in despair, in trouble and in fear, give thanks and talk it over with Jesus, for Jesus is standing by. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Right where you are, hallelujah. Right where you're sitting, whatever struggles that you're going through, whatever circumstances that you have been through, no matter how hard life has fell upon you, there's no situation, no circumstance, nothing that this world can bring against you that God cannot change. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He can change your plight. That even in the midst of your sorrows, in the midst of your tears, that you can still find strength to lift up your hands and say, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you in the good times. Lord, I thank you in the bad times. Lord, I thank you even when I don't even understand, for knowing, oh God, that you are omniscient and you are have great wisdom and you are omnipotent and you have all power. Once it has been said, and twice it has been said, that power belongs to God. Father, you hold the world in your hands. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The earth rotates on its axis because, Lord, because you are the great creator. You are the great I am. Hallelujah. And you can be whatever that we desire you to be. If someone needs a healer, oh God, you are that I am. Lord, if someone needs a healer, hallelujah, you are that I am. Oh God, if someone needs a lawyer, hallelujah, Lord, you are that I am. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, if someone needs their finances, oh God, to be fixed because they are struggling, oh God, to survive, you are that I am. Lord, you are whatever we need you to be. And we give you praise and we give you thanks in the name of Jesus. So right where we are, God, we lift our hands to you and we say thank you, God, for new hope and new joy and new peace and new inspiration, new aspiration, oh God, that in spite of what this world appears to be, God, in spite of what we see on television, Lord, in spite of what's happening in the White House, in spite of what's happening in even, Lord, in Congress, in spite of what's happening, oh God, throughout this election, oh God, Lord, we are not going to falter. We are not going to fail, but we're going to stand firm on our words, Lord. We're going to stand still, and we're going to see your salvation. Your salvation, Lord, is here, God, and you shall reveal your truth, for your truth endureth to all generations. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Just like you brought, oh God, hallelujah, those old Christians down through the years, oh, over 20,000 or 2,000 years, Jesus Christ came, oh God, hallelujah. And we thank you, oh God, for your son, Jesus Christ, that his spirit is yet here with us. Jesus the same yesterday, today, and forever, 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 forevermore. You are forever, oh God. Forever in our hearts, forever in our minds, forever in our spirits. God, we give you praise and we give you thanks. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for providing, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you for opening doors that we have never seen before, oh God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for your protection, oh God. Every time we walk through the streets, oh God. Hallelujah. How you cover us from place to place, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, oh God, for your covering, oh God, for your blood. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. We give you glory, Lord. We give you praise. We are mindful, God, that in everything, hallelujah, in good and in bad, in sickness and in health, in strength and even in weakness. For even when we're weak, oh God, you said that when we're weak, that you will make us strong. Hallelujah. Help us to bear, oh God, and to bear up our cross in the name of Jesus. Help us to lift it high, oh God, that the world might see, oh God, your salvation and your works and your powers, oh God. And may they marvel at us as we lift up your cross to this world that is in need of a Savior. We need you, oh how, God, we need you every day and every hour. We need you, oh Lord. We need you, oh God. And we give you thanks and we give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Thank God and amen. Hallelujah. And right where you are, hallelujah, if you heard this word and this word has touched your hearts, it's very simple just to call on the name of Jesus. This is a time that we need to be calling, hallelujah. And I don't know what you're going through, but you should be calling on his name. For the scripture says that if you confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, ye shall be saved. So right where you are, hallelujah, in submission and spirit, just lift up your hands, hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, in a submission position, and just lift up your hands and say, Father, I thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, I believe that he is the Son of God. Lord, I ask, oh God, that you will forgive me of my sins. Yes, Lord, I acknowledge that I am a sinner and I acknowledge I've done wrong. But right now, God, I commit my life to you, Lord. Come into my heart and save me, Lord. Come into my heart and heal me, oh God. Heal my life, Lord, and change and cleanse and wash me, oh God. Save me and I shall be made whole. I want to live for you, Lord, from this day forward, and I want to magnify and lift up your name, Lord. So thank you, Lord, for saving me, Lord. Thank you, God, for healing me, oh God. Thank you, Lord, for delivering me. Thank you, Lord, for being my Savior. Hallelujah. If you pray that prayer, Just a simple prayer from the tongue of your heart, from your mouth, confessing that you acknowledge that he is the Son of God. You are saved this very moment. In Jesus' name, we pray. Hallelujah. Go in peace and give God thanks. For it is the will. Give him thanks. It is the will concerning you in all of your matters. God bless you. Hallelujah.
Straight! Every Thursday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. as Ephesians of Richmond feeds the harvest. In partnership with the West Contra Costa County School District and the Contra Costa County Food Bank, Ephesians Community Development Center is distributing healthy meal boxes for families. We have boxes that contain dairy, protein, fruits and vegetables, along with supplemental food boxes of non-perishable goods. Supplies are limited and given out on a first-come, first-served basis. Again, that's every Thursday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. We are located in the Richmond Village, and you can pick up your boxes on the corner of South 26th and Cutting Boulevard. You can join in on our virtual worship services on Facebook Live or by subscribing to our YouTube channel, which is Ephesians of Richmond. We invite you to walk through the Bible with us as we present inspiring lessons filled with practical advice for everyday living during our Sunday school. Sunday school takes place at 10 a.m. on Sunday mornings via Zoom. Immediately following Sunday school at 11:30 a.m., we invite you to experience the glory, experience the worship, and experience the praise with us during our virtual morning worship service. The Bible says men ought to always pray, and here at Ephesians, we believe in the power of prayer. Meet us for prayer Monday, Wednesday, and Friday mornings at 7 a.m. on our prayer call. If evenings work better for you, you can join us on Tuesday and Thursday evenings at 6:30 p.m. The number to call in is 669-900-9128. Meeting ID is 723-669-3539. Can't make it to the prayer call but have a prayer request? You may email us your prayer request at ecogicrca@gmail.com. Again, that's ecogicrca@gmail.com, and we will add your prayer to the list. Join us on Tuesday evenings for Bible study. Whether you're a seasoned Bible scholar or a recent convert to Christ, we invite you to expand your knowledge, feed your faith, and become empowered with sound Bible teachings and the Word of God. Coming soon! Join us as we launch the ECDC Technology Center. This will serve as a no-fee computer technology and training center. Grand opening and ribbon-cutting information to follow. If you would like to partner with us here at Ephesians of Richmond and sow a tax-deductible seed into this ministry, we have multiple giving platforms to help you do so. You can go to our webpage at ecogicrca.org and scroll down to the middle of the page where you'll find a link to donate. You may also give via Cash App. Our Cash App ID is $ECOGICRCA. Lastly, you may send your donation to P.O. Box 2950, Richmond, California, 94802. We thank you in advance for supporting the ministries here at Ephesians.